So now let's move on to the financing side. So I hit a very big snag on this side. Hi everyone, I'm Bria Bone, your Austin, Texas real estate professional with the Bone Team. In this video, I'm gonna go over my personal experience buying a new home from a builder. So let's jump right in. So it is March 18th, and I am officially under contract as of last night to buy my very first home. So let's jump right into where I am in the process. So the process of selecting your lot and floor plan will differ depending on the builder. There are some builders where you can choose your favorite lot and then your favorite floor plan and build that home. However, for the specific builder that I'm using, they already had the lots and floor plans paired up. For example, they had lot 1 designated for floor plan A, lot 2 for B, lot 3 for C, and so on. The reason I think they did it this way is because the Austin market has a lot of demand from buyers and a very low supply of homes from sellers and builders. Therefore, it's easier and faster for builders just to pick everything out themselves and get started on the build sooner and with less hassle to them. In fact, the day before I went under contract, I drove out to the community to look at the specific lot, and they have already poured the concrete slab, which is super exciting. So with the lots, I don't really care about the specific location within the community, except that some of the lots back to a greenbelt slash little wooded area. Then for the floor plans, my favorite was the smallest one due to the size and layout, and then the second smallest one, I didn't like the layout, and then the third smallest one, I did like the layout. On that note, I have a little tip for y'all. I recommend viewing more floor plans than you like. So for example, if you like floor plan A, I recommend viewing the two other floor plans that are most similar to it. The reason I suggest that is because you might not end up getting your favorite floor plan, so it's good to have a couple backup options of your second and third choices. So I first visited this community in January and I viewed their three smallest floor plans and got on their interest slash waitlist at that time. They didn't release any lots slash houses in January or February though, and then starting this March, they started releasing a few lots slash houses. I passed over a few lots slash houses though, because they either didn't back to the greenbelt or it was a floor plan that I didn't like. When they released the lot slash house that I'm buying though, I realized that I should have viewed one more floor plan because this one is the fourth smallest floor plan, which would have been the next one that I would have viewed. Based on the rate that they were releasing lot slash houses in my time frame, I was willing to compromise some. This floor plan has a similar layout to my favorite floor plan, however, it's just a couple hundred feet larger than the one that I liked, which was actually the smallest floor plan. My biggest concern was actually the jump up in price from the smallest floor plan to the fourth smallest floor plan. However, prices are increasing so fast in Austin that I decided I would rather just get under contract for a larger floor plan at a seemingly higher price and not have to wait 3 to 4 months and go for the smaller floor plan when those prices likely . Also, I'm happy to announce that I was approved by the builder's lender, so according to them, the price is fine for me. That brings me to my second tip. I recommend speaking with another lender in addition to the builder's lender. Most builders will require you to get pre-approved with their lender, and they usually have some sort of incentive for you to use their lender over an outside one. However, it's in your best interest to get pre-approved with a second lender so you can compare interest rates and closing costs. I've never represented a buyer that hasn't gone with the builder's lender because of what they were able to quote them with the interest rate, closing costs, and incentive. However, I think it's absolutely worth it to go through the process with the second lender so you are able to compare them and have peace of mind that you're choosing the best option for you. So the builder's lender has not quoted me an interest rate or closing costs yet, The only thing that they've quoted me is their incentive of 2% toward closing costs if I use their lender. Once I have the other information from the builder's lender though, I'm going to approach my lender and see what they can quote me. So like the lot and floor plan, the builder's sales rep had already picked out which upgrades they will be including with this home. The first was that the main bathroom's bathtub slash shower was turned into just a shower, so it's not gonna have a tub. To be honest, I'm not a bath person at all, and there will be another bathtub in the other bathroom in the house, so this doesn't really matter to me. The second is that the home comes with a fridge and washer and dryer, which new builds usually don't. However, I've heard and seen that appliances are backed up and people are having trouble getting them. So I think the builder was just wanting to include these because maybe they are able to get appliances easier as a bulk buyer than me just buying them on my own. The two downsides to this are that I don't get to pick out which ones they are, and I actually already own a washer and dryer. I was able to look up the fridge that they selected and it's not bad, however it's not the one I would have picked out myself. To be honest, I had it in my head that I was gonna get a black fridge. I've seen those and they just look so cool, but this one is the more traditional stainless steel, so I'm just gonna have to go with that. And then with the washer and dryer, I wasn't able to find them online. However, I don't really care about this that much, so if I like them, I'll probably just sell my washer and dryer, which are a few years old anyways, and keep those. The other downside is that the cost of these three appliances is built into the home sale price, which means that it is going to be part of the mortgage and I will be paying interest on them for 30 years. If it were up to me, I would have just bought these with cash after closing, so it's a little frustrating to me that I'm gonna have to pay interest on them for 30 years. And on that note, I have another tip for y'all. Most builders will let you choose if you want to add any upgrades, and if so, which ones. If so, I recommend choosing the big ticket items first and ones that are more of a hassle to complete later. For example, is it worth paying interest on ceiling fans for 30 years? Probably not, but it may be worth it for flooring. Also, most sales reps will try to sell you on as many upgrades as possible because they're trying to make as much money as possible for their builder. However, please note that you do not need to max out your pre-approval amount with features and upgrades. It never hurts to stay below budget if possible, which brings me to my next tip. Builders negotiate on incentives, not price, so if you're trying to get more bang for your buck, I recommend to not ask them to decrease the home sale price. To be honest, it makes sense to me why they don't want to do that, because it messes up their comps, which are comparable home sales. So, for example, say that they sell home number one for $300,000 and then a month later a buyer comes along for home number two. They can say to the buyer, look, home one sold for $300,000 and it's been a month, so home two is priced at $305,000. If they try to sell home number one for $300,000, but the price ends up being negotiated down to $295,000, then the price for home two in this scenario would be $300,000. Therefore, by negotiating just that one home's sale price down, it impacts all of the other homes that are going to be built and has a huge decrease on their total profit. Therefore, most builders prefer to negotiate on incentives, and I recommend asking for incentives instead of a decrease in price. So like I said earlier, the builder's rep told me they would pay 2% toward my closing costs if I use their lender. That's probably the most widespread incentive that you will see builders using. Other incentives could be upgrading flooring for free or anything along that line. Unfortunately, at the time of this video, the Austin market has so many buyers out there that builders don't really need to offer many incentives. So for my situation, the only one that I'm going to be receiving, and I did ask for more than just this one, is that 2% decrease in closing costs. Now I want to touch on why I'm buying a new home versus a resale home, which is an already built home. As I mentioned before, Austin has a lot of demand from buyers and a very low supply of homes from sellers and builders. Therefore, a lot of homes are receiving multiple offers from multiple buyers and therefore driving up the price and making the terms way more favorable for sellers than for buyers. In my price range, I was almost certain that any home I wanted to buy would be in a multiple offer situation and turn into a bidding war. To remove some of the stress and uncertainty of that, I decided to go for a new build instead. Generally, builders accept buyers on a first-come, first-served basis. There are some builders that have moved to multiple offers slash bidding wars right now because of how much demand they have. However, for the most part, you will see them have a first-come, first-served policy. They will have some sort of price increase system set in place though, like for example, every 3 homes we sell, we increase the price by $5,000. However, that system will be more stable than getting into a bidding war. Also, I like the idea of buying a new home. I've lived in a range of apartments, some brand new, some pretty old, and some in between, and by far my favorite ones have been the newer ones. Also, I like the idea that it's going to be built as perfect as possible, so I'll have less maintenance in the first couple years, and I will have a builder's warranty for a year. Lastly, I like the idea that the home will be more energy efficient than an older one. The biggest downside that I can think of right now is that the landscaping will be immature. However, one of the very first things I want to do when I buy the house is plant a few trees. If you want me to film that and any other improvements I make when I move in, let me know and I could start a little new home series. Hello again. So it is Monday, July 19th. It has been quite some time since I've spoken to y'all. However, I know y'all just saw me a couple of seconds ago. If you're still watching, please give this video a big thumbs up with the like button and subscribe to my channel. It really helps me with the YouTube algorithm and I would greatly appreciate it. So I have a lot to catch y'all up on. So let's start with the build side of things. So that has gone extremely well. I've been very happy with the sales rep and then the on-site manager. I had my third party inspection about a week ago and that went well. There were about 10 items that came back, which is pretty common with new construction or any home that's in extremely good condition. It's very common that it'll come back with 10 or so items. And then I have my blue tape walkthrough and new home orientation in 2 days. So the blue tape walkthrough is when you walk through with a roll of blue tape and you put little pieces on little issues you have. So for example, the wall that's behind me is supposed to be distressed, but let's say it was supposed to be all white. You put a piece of tape, let's see, can you see that? No, you can't. It's kind of hard to see what I'm seeing. Okay, so you put a piece of tape right here and say, okay, that needs to be fixed. And then one here, and you just tape it right there. So you go through the whole house and it's mostly paint that you'll be marking, but sometimes it's other issues that you come across. And then the following Wednesday, which is the day before closing, then we have the final walkthrough, which is to make sure all of the little things we marked with blue tape have been fixed and that no new issues have come up. And then Thursday, the 29th, will be the closing. So now let's move on to the financing side. So I hit a very big snag on this side. There was something that the lender needed me to provide, and they told me that at the very end of June. And then they told me at the beginning of July, I think it was July 1st, that we potentially had a problem. And then we tried to solve it a couple of different ways and it didn't work out. And then they let me know at the end of the first week that it was not going to work out and that I needed to find my own lender. I was very upset about this. This was something that they always knew they were going to need me to provide. And I got pre-approved with them back in mid-March when I first went under contract. So I was upset that they waited until this point to tell me that, because I would have known back then that it was going to be an issue if they brought it up to me. So I'm upset that they waited until the last minute. So they told me the end of the first week that I was not approved by them. So then I immediately applied with a second lender, got first pre-approved with them, and then I found out last Friday that I am fully approved with them and the appraisal has been done and the results of that should be available this Thursday, so in 3 days. So this brings me to my next point, is that it is extremely important that you have a real estate professional representing you on a real estate transaction, whether you're buying a resale home or a new build home. A lot of times the builder's reps will say that it's not necessary to have a realtor represent you. However, when something goes wrong, because there will be something that goes wrong during the process, you really want someone who works for you and you know has your back on your side during that time. So everything is going super well on the financing side now. We hit a very big snag, but I think it's gonna work out. It's not uncommon to hit snags or issues as you go through a real estate transaction. In fact, I think every single transaction I've gone through, even the ones that I felt like went extremely well, all had something come up during the transaction. So of course it's not fun when you're in the position where it's impacting you, but so if you're watching this video right now, that means that I successfully closed and bought my house. I'm not gonna post it unless that happens. So I'm just really hoping everything else works out really well. The last part is sort of like the title company's role. I haven't really interacted with the builder's title company yet. That's gonna kind of come into play in the next couple weeks. But I'm not anticipating having any issues with them. So if you're interested in seeing the fun part of this process and all of the videos and photos I took during the process of the build, I will be posting that video in a week and I will have that linked below this one, or you can just look on my channel. It'll be the video right next to this one. So thank you so much for watching and I'll see y'all in my next video.